I'm Norbert Gleicher, MD, and I'm the medical director and chief scientist here at the Center for Human Reproduction in New York City. A subject of our presentation today is the use of human growth hormone. And the reason why we have chosen to make yet another video on this subject is that we have seen an explosive, really explosive growth of utilization of human growth hormone in infertile women. And to be honest, we are kind of puzzled by this observation. We are puzzled because we haven't seen in parallel the studies that one would expect in support of such an increase. Indeed, there is very, very little supportive data to really suggest that human growth hormone supplementation in fertile women does make much of a difference. There are some data that suggest that in certain women with infertility, human growth hormone supplementation may increase the number of eggs that are obtained in an IVF cycle. And there's a certain logic to making the argument that if one gets more eggs, one has more embryos, and if one has more embryos, in the end, one sees better pregnancy rates or cumulative pregnancy chances for patients. And as I said, this argument makes sense, but at the same time, we also have to be honest and acknowledge that there's really not a single study in the medical literature to really strongly support the hypothesis that human growth hormone supplementation in any woman with infertility really improves her pregnancy and live birth chances. So that's important to understand when the subject comes up for discussion. Now, why is there such an increase in human growth hormone usage? Well, I said already before that we are puzzled, and we really do not have a good answer for it. The honest truth is probably that this, at least to some extent, may be yet just another one of these fashions of the moment that we here at CHR have been talking about on and off for many, many years. Medicine is not very different from other areas in life. We too have our fashions of the moment. And I'm old enough to remember times a few decades back when human growth hormone was the thing to do. And then it kind of disappeared from practice, probably because there was no strong evidence that it would improve IVF outcomes or any other treatment outcomes in infertility. And human growth hormone is very expensive. Now, what may have contributed to the resurgence is that over the last few years, quite a number of different manufacturers have come to market with their own human growth hormone products. And as a consequence, prices have somewhat decreased. And that may have been a motivation for increasing use. We here at CHR do not like to follow fashions of the moment, as most of our viewers probably already know. And when we do introduce a new treatment, then we usually introduce it within the framework of a clinical study. And we indeed have two registered clinical trials for the use of human growth hormone ongoing at CHR. And we very much try to convince our patients to take this treatment, if they choose to take this treatment, within the framework of one of those clinical trials. We obviously do not and cannot force them to do that, and so some patients simply prefer not to participate in a clinical trial. But in general, if we can make a recommendation, before using human growth hormone, discuss with your physician its efficacy. It will be interesting to hear what they have to say. I hope we have clarified this still quite controversial issue for you. Please do not hesitate to contact us if you have any further questions. Thanks for listening.